Jacob M. presents Prime Ministerial Elections in Canadian History.
The 33rd Canadian federal election took place on September 4th, 1984, after a snap election was called and Parliament was dissolved by Governor General Jean Sauve. A fun fact about Governor General Sauve is that she was the first female Canadian Governor General. Throughout the country, there was a deep political divide. The Liberals had very few seats west of Ontario, where the Conservatives and NDP dominated Western Canadian politics. This east and west divide still remains today, where the Western Canadian provinces often vote Conservative and the Eastern provinces vote Liberal. Prime Minister Trudeau's first challenge came soon after he took office in 1980, because in May of the same year, just a couple months after the election concluded, the Quebec sovereignty referendum occurred. The referendum was called by the Parti Québécois leader and Quebec Premier René Lévesque. The referendum was a vote on whether Quebec should separate and declare its own separate country from Canada. Trudeau immediately got involved in the referendum. He began supporting the no side of the referendum and began delivering speeches for Quebec to remain with Canada. Trudeau's involvement reversed the previous Clark government stance of leaving Quebec issues for Quebec to solve. Trudeau proposed that if the no side won, he'd introduce new legislation that English Canadians would have to listen and solve issues concerning Quebecers in Quebec. When the referendum day finally came, 60% of Quebecers voted to remain with Canada, and Trudeau's involvement proved to play a huge part in this decision. However, Trudeau wouldn't keep the whole country united. Trudeau further alienated Western Canadians when the Liberal budget was introduced and had many oil and gas resources and profits go toward the federal government rather than the provinces in order to pay for social programs. It was also during this time that Canada patriated our constitution from the United Kingdom. Basically, this meant that Canada could now change its own laws and create new ones instead of making a law and having it approved by the United Kingdom first before being enacted into Canadian law. This was done when the House of Commons drafted a patriation bill, which passed and was later sent to the United Kingdom, where it also passed through the House of Commons there. This became known as the Constitution Act of 1982 and was signed by Queen Elizabeth II, since she's also the Queen of Canada. During this time, Canada was going through a recession. The recession of 1981 to 82 was seen as the worst economic recession to hit Canada since the 1930s. Unemployment in Canada started to rise and GDP fell drastically. Oil and gas prices began to rise, which hurt Canadians financially, and the Liberal government in power was blamed for not doing enough to help Canadians. Prime Minister Trudeau became very unpopular with Canadians as a result of this. On February 29th, 1984, Pierre Trudeau announced he would not be leading the Liberals into another election. A Liberal leadership election was held to succeed Trudeau as leader and Prime Minister of Canada. There were a lot of candidates running to replace Trudeau, but only three really stood out. There was Don Johnston, the Member of Parliament for St. Henri-Westmount and President of the Treasury Board, John Turner, the former Member of Parliament for Ottawa-Orléans and the former Minister of Finance before his resignation in 1976 and retirement from politics. Turner stood out because he was out of politics for a long time and was very young when he was in cabinet, serving with both Prime Minister Lester Pearson and Pierre Trudeau. After resigning in 1976, he went back to practicing law and working in Bay Street, which is pretty much Canada's version of Wall Street. He was also a candidate for leadership in 1968, but lost to Pierre Trudeau. And finally, there was Jean Chrétien, the Member of Parliament for St. Maurice and Minister of Energy. Chrétien also played a big role in the Quebec referendum and campaigning for the no side. The race looked to be tight between Chrétien and Turner. Both of them were very popular with the Liberal Party and both looked to make good prime ministers. In the end, it would take two ballots to decide the victor, and John Turner would beat Jean Chrétien by a close margin. John Turner succeeded Pierre Trudeau and was sworn in as the 17th Prime Minister of Canada. John Turner was born in England, making him the first Prime Minister to be born outside of Canada since Mackenzie Bowl. He was also the first Prime Minister since John Abbott to never sit in the House of Commons while being appointed as Prime Minister. In his final days in office, Trudeau recommended that Governor General appoint 200 Liberal patronage appointments. Patronage is pretty much rewarding individuals for supporting a political party. These appointments included judges, senators, and executives in various government and crown corporations. This caused heavy public backlash. It wouldn't help that Turner would appoint another 70 patronage appointments after Trudeau left office. 9 days after being sworn in as Prime Minister, Turner requested Parliament's dissolution and an election began. This was a controversial move since Turner could have governed for a full year before having an election. Going into the election, the PC Party was no longer led by Joe Clark. This was because a third of delegates at the 1981 Conservative Convention were dissatisfied with Joe Clark's leadership and were in favor of having a leadership convention. This would occur in 1983 after a party leadership convention was called and Joe Clark's leadership was challenged. Like in the Liberal leadership election, there were a few candidates, but only three stood out. There was Joe Clark, the former Prime Minister and Member of Parliament for Yellowhead and current party leader, who was fighting to keep his job, John Crosby, the Member of Parliament for St. John's West and former Minister of Finance, and there was Brian Mulroney, the former President of the Iron Ore Company of Canada. Mulroney ran against Clark in the 1976 leadership election, but placed third. In the last election, he was seen as an outsider, but in this leadership race, he was seen as capable of beating the Liberals. Mulroney attracted lots of pro-business delegates at the convention, most delegates from Toronto and Montreal. Mulroney's main pitch was that he was fluently bilingual and a native Quebecer, and that he would be able to break the Liberal stronghold in Quebec if he was elected leader. In the leadership race, Mulroney and Crosby laid down the groundwork for the Anyone But Clark movement. This was because at this point, no one had faith in Joe Clark's leadership. Mulroney started mobilizing anti-Clark sentiment to his side, and in the end, Clark would have to get 50% on the first ballot if he'd want to remain leader, which he didn't, and he only received 36.7%, with Mulroney closely behind with 34.6%. It would take four ballots to decide the winner, and Clark gained less and less votes each time, and Mulroney gained more and more, which led to his victory as the new leader of the Progressive Conservative Party. On the election campaign, Turner's Liberals ran on improving relations with the United States, lowering the national debt, and creating new job creation programs. Turner wouldn't attract a wide audience, as many Canadians didn't know much about him. Turner also stood out because he didn't have a seat in the House of Commons going into the election. He announced he was running in a Vancouver riding during the election instead of seeking to enter the House of Commons through a by-election. Not long into the election campaign, Turner was caught touching two female Liberal Party members inappropriately on TV, which caused outrage among Canadians. The Liberals also started their campaign later than the other parties and were not prepared for the election. Turner's second blunder was when he said in a campaign stop in Manitoba that the province of Manitoba had a rising unemployment rate because the people were leaving the province, which wasn't true and the population was growing. Mulroney went into the election with the benefit of not being John Turner. He also campaigned for lowering the national debt and making the economy better. Being from Quebec, voters in Quebec began supporting Brian Mulroney over other candidates running for prime minister. Mulroney's leadership was pretty much a large coalition. He appealed to Western Canadians who felt alienated, the more progressive Eastern Canadians, Quebecers, and pro-business voters. He also appealed to Quebec nationalists, which included those who supported Quebec sovereignty, since Mulroney promised to keep Pierre Trudeau's policy of having Quebec problems be solved and treated equally to other Canadian problems. But he also had his share of mishaps during the election. Notably, when he announced he would be making patronage appointments himself, since he was convinced he would win the election. The NDP during this time benefited from the Liberals' poor performance. Ed Broadbent, the NDP leader, was still very popular, and his party was still seen as a better alternative to the Liberals. This election would be the first to feature a televised French debate. This came after the English debate, though. The English debate was perhaps the most important for the election. It was here that the three party leaders, Ed Broadbent, John Turner, and Brian Mulroney, squared off. At the debate, Turner attacked Mulroney for his plans of patronage appointments. Turner's attack backfired, and Mulroney retaliated, which caused this iconic moment.
You, sir, owe the Canadian people a deep apology for having indulged in that kind of practice with those kinds of appointments.
Well, I've told you and told the Canadian people, Mr. Mulroney, that I had no option.
Well, Truman, your next question. You had an option, sir. You could have said, I am not going to do it. This is wrong for Canada, and I am not going to ask Canadians to pay the price. You had an option, sir, to say no, and you chose to say yes to the old attitudes and the old stories of the Liberal Party. That, sir, if I may say respectfully, that is not good enough for Canadians.
I had no option if I was able
That is an avowal of failure. That is a confession of non-leadership, and this country needs leadership. You had an option, sir. You could have done better.
The "you had an option" quote pretty much solidified Turner's downfall in the election. The public began favoring Mulroney more and more and were very angry at the Liberals' history of corruption and patronage appointments. And here are the results. Brian Mulroney easily won, becoming the 18th Prime Minister of Canada. He won 211 seats, 111 more since the last election. Brian Mulroney seemingly destroyed John Turner. This was and still is the largest majority ever won by a Prime Ministerial candidate in Canada's history. Mulroney beat former Prime Minister John Diefenbaker's record majority by 3 seats, and this was the first Conservative majority since the election of 1958. Mulroney received 50.03% of the popular vote. In second second place was John Turner with 49 seats, 95 less than in the previous election. Turner's loss came over his early call of an election, overall unpreparedness, and bad ethical government legacy. He finished with 28.02% of the popular vote. In third place was the NDP with 30 seats, one less than in the previous election. Ed Broadbent's popularity caused the NDP to win a ton of seats, almost replacing the Liberal Party for second place. The NDP finished with 18.81% of the popular vote.